Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
So, Corey, go ahead and let's intro the thing.
Yeah, put on your
eyeliner. All right, here we go, guys. directed by Matt Reeves, Robert Pattinson will be taking up the cowl to play a very young Bruce Wayne in The Batman.
Celebrity. Why is he writing to you?
If you are justice, please do not lie. What is the price for your blind eye?
The hell are you supposed to be?
I'm vengeance.
Whoa! This guy's crazy!
All right, guys, that was the trailer for The Batman.
The Batman.
That's how
they define things now. It's the Suicide Squad.
Yeah.
This is The Batman. That old one was Batman. This is
Batman.
The Batman. So it's now time for the preview review portion. Let's start with you, Matt. What did you think of The Batman teaser?
So, obviously, as everyone just saw it, this sets up a very, very brutal version of Batman. Obviously, the Nolan movies were very, very popular. I love them. You love them. Everyone, statistically, you do. Those were pretty dark for superhero movies of the time. This makes Nolan Batman look like, you know, looks like Batman Forever. You know,
Batman Forever is the one with bat nipples, right?
Yeah, they.
No, I think Batman and Robin is.
Oh yeah, Batman and Robin is bat nipples. Okay.
Yeah. No. So yeah, Batman Forever is Jim Carrey.
Yes. Yes.
And
Tommy Lee Jones.
Val Kilmer.
Just eating the scenery.
Val Kilmer is boring as hell.
Right. Well, I said that one because they both, that movie and this film, have the Riddler in it. Mm-hmm. This is a completely different world. Whereas in like that movie, they took the Riddler and made him way campier even somehow. this is the same thing in exactly the opposite direction. Mm-hmm. The Riddler's super like dark and serious like. all that stuff. Catwoman is here, and she looks like an actual cat burglar. Yeah. Like, yeah. this is a universe where people don't necessarily just randomly dress up like an animal for no reason. She just looks like an actual cat burglar. This trailer is interesting. As I was watching it, it just made me think of something that a big cliche in trailers now is they all have big, like, oppressive, like boom sounds every, like, 20 seconds. It's like, hey, this is a dark universe. Yeah, that's all over this trailer. Batman literally looks like the Crow at the end of the trailer. So if you went through a super, super goth phase in high school, this is your Batman movie. This is the Batman. This is what they're trying to, I mean, and I mean, that's what the trailer is setting up the plot, but it's a very vibe heavy trailer.
Oh yeah. You know, it's, oh yeah.
This is dark. This is the Dark Knight.
This
isn't the Dark Knight.
Director Matt Reeves cites, it's funny that, because when we watched the Suicide Squad sneak peek, that they said it was like a 1970s gritty war movie. Now, director Matt Reeves for this one cites 1970s crime dramas, and this is way more seen in this this inspiration of that versus the Suicide Squad.
Yeah.
Definitely not any inspiration from 1970s war movies. But with this, he cites The French Connection, Taxi Driver, and Chinatown.
Yeah. And there's grit, and then there's you're caught in the bottom of a pit, and the pit is lined with sandpaper. That's this trailer.
Yeah.
You know.
To your point of Paul Dano's Riddler looking totally opposite, to me, it looks like he's taking storylines from, Corey, maybe you've read this, but Batman's Hush. Have you read that at all? When you do get to see the Riddler, he's got, like, bandages all over his face and stuff. It's very reminiscent of, from the Hush comics, you know, that character has bandages over his face, and it has a big part in Bruce Wayne's past life and all that. Definitely, I recommend that as a comic read for anyone. But they might be, from this teaser trailer, it looks like they might be fusing Riddler and the Hush character together, which I think Paul Dano is a great actor just in general, and bringing the Riddler to life in this super dark way, I think he does a good job. He also cites comic stories that I haven't read, which is The Long Halloween and a short story from something called Batman Ego. So check those out if you're interested. When you first get a look at his suit, first thing I thought was the Daredevil Netflix series suit, for whatever reason, just because of how dark this trailer was in terms of even just lighting. When I first saw it, it has like weird platings over it, just like the Daredevil suit did.
Everyone in Gotham has a vitamin D deficiency.
I'm definitely hyped about this, but I am skeptical due to DC's track record the handling of, you know, the recent handlings of big name superheroes. Well, hopefully this will work out though. There's a lot of different stars in it. Corey, you mentioned that, I think, while we were watching the trailer, which they didn't get to hear. So maybe you could shine some light on that and then go into your opinion. So,
yeah, of course. So, obviously we already talked about Robert Pattinson, but Zoe Kravitz will be playing Selina Kyle as Catwoman. Colin Farrell is going to be Oswald Cobblepot, who eventually becomes the Penguin. We already talked about Paul Dano. Andy Serkis is going to be Alfred Pennyworth, which is really cool. John Turturro, I didn't realize was going to be in this film because he's nowhere in the trailer, but he's going to be playing Mob Syndicate Carmine Falcone, Falcone, depending on how you pronounce it.
It depends on the iteration, right? If the E is silent or not.
Yeah. Jeffrey Wright is going to be James Gordon. I'm very excited to see him take on that role. It's just DC's problem recently with live action films has always been trying to jam too much into one place. So the fact that you have Catwoman and the Penguin, and the Riddler. And, you know, that's just what's announced right now. And Carmine Falcone. It's just, it could be too much too soon for what might just be a one-off film, you know?
Yeah.
That being said, Fernandez mentioned the long Halloween, and I have a little quick run-through of what that storyline is. So the long Halloween in comic terms was actually... is actually considered the sequel to Batman Year One, which is another graphic novel that this film draws inspiration from. So this is at the point where Harvey Dent has not become Two-Face yet. He's just district attorney who's working with Captain James Gordon and the Batman to take down serial killers and minor, you know, stuff like that. So while they're trying to take down the Marioni and the Falcone crime families, a killer named Holiday pops up in Gotham and says he's going to murder somebody every Tuesday until Halloween, and he shows up in, like, August or something.
Oh, the Calendar Man, right?
Yeah. Well, it's not Calendar Man. Calendar Man actually knows who is the Holiday killer, but refuses to tell Batman because he's a fucking psychopath. A choo-choo psychopath. But this is the storyline that eventually leads into Harvey Dent becoming... Two-Face. It's like the accident that causes that.
Yeah.
And then, you know, Scarecrow and Joker and Mad Hatter and Poison Ivy are there too. Whatever.
That just works better in comic books than it does on screen.
In film. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You could just have seven villains, you know, in the comic. It just works. It doesn't work on screen.
Yeah, it's funny because Fernandez also referenced Hush, which was recently as early as last year or the year before, they made a Hush animated film, which kind of cut and weaved that story into a nice little bundle.
Yeah, I've yet to watch that one.
Man.
The comic was really good, though, so I do need to watch that one.
It is very good. I enjoyed it a lot, and I think we also might see parts of what lead to Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League in that animated film as well.
Very cool.
One thing you didn't mention, though, Corey, was Colin Farrell. In the trailer, you get to see some random dude, you know, with like, kind of a chubby face, older guy.
Mm-hmm.
That's actually Colin Farrell in prosthetic makeup, it looks like, to be Cobblepot, Oswald Cobblepot.
I think I've actually seen some stills online.
Yeah.
Here, you can throw it up right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, there it is. Look at him. He's gross.
Picture of, yeah. With that being said, so I have another like little rant underneath my notes here that I'd like to read. So
Fernandez's notes are 90% rant and side notes.
Well, actually, this part actually comes from because before we started to record, I was just looking into some more stuff because I needed to look into more of like. I was trying to remember all the crap that happened in the like making of the first Justice League with Joss Whedon and all the stuff that happened. And I came across something, the Flash movie, they didn't release any trailer for or anything for the DC fandom, but they just had a panel and they talked about some interesting stuff. So these are just rumors now from what I'm gathering. But I mentioned this, I think, earlier on. But anyway, Corey, you're probably familiar with, obviously, the Flashpoint film.
Yes,
and the Flashpoint comics, all that stuff. And how the Flash, Barry Allen, goes back in time and makes a time rift and everything. And mm-hmm. it messes with the timeline and everything gets all screwed up. So that's going to be, I think, the way DC is going to tie in all these films. Is have Barry Allen go back in time, mess with the timeline, and then everything is now connected because the people that are rumored for the Flash movie, you got Ben Affleck's Batman returning. You Love have it. Rumored of Michael Keaton's Batman coming back for an appearance.
Love it. Love
so
it.
So my thing, and I'm super excited for that, you know, but it also gives DC now like basically free reign to reboot whatever they want. And, or if anything fails, they're like, well, that's just a different timeline. Let's just read it. It kind of gives them an easy out now, which is always the case with time travel stuff.
Oh man!
But what I think would be really awesome is if Michael Keaton's Batman does make an appearance in the Flash movie, is to, he, since he's so much older now, is to have a Terry McGinnis reveal for Batman Beyond, maybe being a character.
God, I would.
That would be awesome.
Love it.
That was basically my little rant paragraph at the end there that I put in my notes.
Fernandez talking about alternate timelines just had me picture some fat studio executive with like tiny glasses and suspenders just going, oh, well, that's a different timeline. That's not even connected. So we're just going to make this movie anyway, and you'll just deal with it. But that's almost because I've heard similar rumors about Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, or whatever they're calling it, is like that's also Marvel's excuse to be like, well, we want a new Spider-Man, or we want a new Captain America, or we want a new Falcon.
Well, they already have like, that out just, with the time travel thing they did in Endgame, Avengers Endgame.
Yeah. Even though this is the limited edition DC fandom round trip hype train, I think it is worth noting, rest in peace, Chadwick Boseman passed yesterday.
Yes.
And he will be missed by many.
Yeah, hearing that news, I was pretty stunned. It was, you texted Corey, and I saw it, and I was like, looking that you actually had, it was multiple posts that you sent like a picture of from different news outlets. I was like, no, I couldn't believe it. I had to check it myself on all these different other things to be like, there's no way.
Right.
And because I didn't even know he was sick. And
no one did. Like a very small.
And when I found like other news articles, I was like, wow, did me that.
It will be greatly missed.
Yeah.
Wakanda forever.
Wakanda forever. All right. Who wants to intro Gotham Knights?
Yeah,
I can do it.
We didn't do it.
I was just going to do it.
We didn't boom or bust.
Oh, it's boom or bust.
Boom.
Boom.
Boom for Corey.
Boom.
Boom for Mike. Boom, boom for Sanford. Moving on.
Booming.
hashtag booming. Hashtag hype train. Hashtag follow us on Twitter. We got one of those.
Hashtag
we're
Batman.
So professional, you guys.
Hashtag the Batman in Boom, like in Bloom by Nirvana, who sang the song during the trailer, but not in Bloom.
But you guys didn't hear that because we got copyrights.
Hey, yes. You know what?
We don't know that yet.
Yeah, and we're such a small channel. I don't think anyone cares anymore.
You think so? Prince seemed to care.
R. Oh, R. yeah, Prince cared a lot. Go check out our Prince episode on Graffiti Bridge.
Link below.
Okay.
Please step aside and let the customers off the train first.